Here's Tkachuk. Now up to the point for Brandon Montour. He slides it across, back down to Tkachuk, low side. Binnington was there, tracking it all the way. Now right up front. Kyrou tries to get the shot. It's blocked in front once again by Luostarinen. Now here's Crew. Knight can't see it, it's behind him, and it's in! The point shot off the board.
Says to the guys, I'll take it. The Blues on the second power play are trying to shoot the puck more frequently. A couple shots in a row blocked, one by Gudas, one by Luostarinen. Crew's shot goes all the way through, and when Spencer Knight can't find it, it's going to hit his left foot just outside the post, deflects into the net, the Blues on the power play.
One thing to keep in mind as well, not only just a second game in two nights, the Panthers played some players really big minutes last night.
There's a shot coming off the stick of Tyler Tucker, the rookie defenseman. Denisenko working away in the corner. Here's Ryan Lomberg, who pulls it out. Knocked off the puck, back down to Luostarinen, and puts it right out front. And the shot coming off the stick of Denisenko, but Binnington was there.
A good effect on Montour as well, playing with him as a tandem this year.
And here comes Sammy Blais on his backhand, cutting in, puts it towards the net. Now Alexander Barkov working away, but Buchnevich regains the puck, but now it's Barkov. Barkov puts it across to Tkachuk. Verhaeghe's with them. Tkachuk drops it back. Here's Forsling, takes the shot. Binnington with a save, rebound in front, but Barkov can't get the shot off, and Saad will collect.
I think, you know, talking to some of the players, the break was a real chance to kind of focus, regroup a little bit, and I think that's especially.
Matthew Tkachuk puts this one in front. The shot is blocked, and Brayden Schenn will turn it around for St. Louis as he's Kyrou with him. Schenn takes the shot. He scores. Brayden Schenn with his 14th of the season.
Coolest thing I've seen in a while. As this shift was going on, they announced the Tory Crew goal was actually Brayden Schenn's goal. He must have deflected. So that was his 14th. This is his 15th. As Schenn picks up the turnover and carries it all the way up the ice. Spencer Knight plays this as a 2-on-1 and gets beat clean. Schenn can really lean on this wrister, Dom, and he makes no mistake.
And the play started in the defensive zone. It was Jordan.
This is starting to look like second game in two nights here as Nick Leddy's going to jump on this loose puck. He's a terrific skater, easy skater. And he goes all the way through the Panthers. Another goal on the blocker side, or on the glove side. Pretty similar to Brayden Schenn. Schenn's was low.
Krickle will slide it across. Here's Kyrou again. Floats it in low. Robert Thomas back on it. He slides it across ice. There's a shot and he scores! Back-to-back goals by defenseman as Justin Falk has the Blues up 4-0.
The Panthers are dead in the water here. No energy, no zip. Everybody staring at the puck, and now Justin Falk gets to walk in clean from the point. This is the third one that beats Spencer Knight on the glove side. Really sweet feed, though, from Robert Thomas, and Falk has all kinds of room.
They're trying to find a good look at it, but it has to be conclusive, so we'll have to see what they find.
So it's when Knight shoots the puck, and whether it went up high enough or not.
It didn't. It looked like Robert Thomas just stopped it with his stick, and Mark Stahl, right here, you're going to see Thomas knock it down with his stick, and Mark Stahl saying that that's a high stick play.
After reviewing the play, there was a high stick prior to the goal. Therefore, we have no goal. Please reset the clock to 5:10.
Ryan O'Reilly remaining blue. This is all said and done.
Long shot doesn't get through the layers. Now batted right back down below the goal line. Senator right up front, and Billington can't stop this one as the Panthers are now on the board.
And after all that mess of things, games for him. Tkachuk will find this puck when it gets behind the net, and he's going to get to it first. Shield Tucker, lift his stick to get control. That's a nifty little play. Look at that. Lifted the stick. Now he's able to slide it out in front. Luostarinen
is right at the goal crease. That's a career high goals for him. Goals in back-to-back nights.
It's also a career high in points. He now is.
Yeah, and now they've got the Blues scrambling around here. They can't get the puck out of their zone, and finally it bounces out.
And here they come working down and score! Centers for the captain, and he's got his second goal in as many games.
Games of that year. We used to call this the reverse trap. We'd hem a team in our end for so long they got tired, and then we'd hope for a bounce. Here's the bounce. Buchnevich is going to get the puck, slide it wide, and go through the middle to find Ryan O'Reilly. Florida had totally dominated the last 5 minutes of this period.
Ryan O'Reilly.
Blues coming back with numbers. Kyrou puts it down low for Thomas. He's being watched by Mom. Thomas now takes the shot, looking for Kyrou. He scores. Jordan Kyrou on the back step. And the Blues are cruising. They now have five.
Kyrou's got plenty of room through the middle of the ice to make this initial play, and then Thomas protects. These two connect on a beautiful give and go. Jordan Kyrou goes to the net, and Robert Thomas snaps this right through the goal crease as Mark Stahl doesn't seal the back post. Now, if you're in a white jersey right now, this clock can't tick fast enough.
Kachuk just inside the line, over to Verhaeghe. He floats it on net, and he scores!
Wow, what a shot.
Verhaeghe beats Binnington. And that's two goals now for the Panthers as they cut the lead to three.
In and out in the Tampa lineup, they didn't have any real cap space. And Florida signed him as a free agent. And he's proven to be a legit NHL scorer. Look at this release. That is a quick bullet through the legs of Noah Lachari up over the glove of Binnington.
Ricocheted off the Panthers player to negate the icing there.
Oh, and here's a steal. Barbashev fires it towards, and he hits the mesh. Barbashev with the empty net marker, putting this one out of reach.
Pretty messy minute and a half without the goaltender in the net. A couple of icings, a couple of pucks down the ice, and another Florida missed pass coming out of the zone, and Ivan Barbashev's got an easy one as he picks up the loose puck. 8 or 9 games to the deadline, and 20 games past that for them to try and make up the ground.